knows how you come across somebody once in a while you shouldn't have messed with. That's me. Well,
I walk back down. I am not an African American.
You're Oreo cookie. White in the inside and black on the outside.
I don't have an Afro. I have an Amerifro.
Talking that idiotic stuff you talk about, I will slap you.
Go ahead. Make my day.
Black at the Ace of Spades, but 100% American. Heard around the world by everybody and their mama. The Jesse Lee Peterson Radio Show.
United the races with truth instead of dividing them with lies. We also rebuilding the family by rebuilding the man. I am Jesse Lee Peterson. Welcome to the second hour of the show already. Time is just, flying by. I don't know what the rush is. In the next hour, the third hour today, Manhood Hour, we're going to be talking with Pastor Ted Haggard. You do not want to miss out on that interview coming up in the next hour. I am taking your phone calls at 888-775-3773, 888-77-JESSE. I have with me a woman that I admire for her courage, Naomi Schaefer Riley. Naomi Schaefer Riley writes about higher education, religion, and culture. She appears on Fox News and Fox Business. She has lectured at Hillsdale College, NYU, and Notre Dame, and has written books including Till Faith Do Us Part, How Interfaith Marriage is Transforming America. And we're going to tell you how to get to her books. I wanted to talk to her about an article she wrote, Jay-Z, a poor excuse for a husband. Naomi, good morning and welcome to the show.
Good morning. Thanks for having me.
It's an honor to meet you. I respect your courage.
Thank you.
And my baby sister name is Naomi.
So, I don't find too many of them.
I know. Well, thank you for being with us. I want to talk to you first about this article you wrote, Jay-Z, a poor excuse for a husband, in response to his wife performance, Beyonce performance at the Grammy Award a couple Sunday nights ago. First, tell the folks what happened with Beyonce and why do you call Jay-Z a poor excuse for a husband?
Well, you know, I think for years, women have been performing at the Grammys, you know, scantily clad. They have been doing all sorts of sexually explicit things on stage. I've been shocked at the hour at which it happens. You know, 8 o'clock, I find this on my television, on network television.
Yes.
But I have to say I was really blown away to turn on the television at 8 o'clock and find Beyonce performing what, you know, might as well have been a striptease for all any of us really care about the difference, while her husband was standing there. I don't know what kind of husband wants to see their wife, you know, take it all off and do that in front of millions of other people. Is this now the new standard for the way husbands and wives behave in public?
I have to tell you, when I saw it, I was shocked, and I'm a man, and I was just absolutely shocked. I didn't watch the Grammys. I saw it by way of the Internet the day or so later. And when I saw this woman doing that and the way she was dancing with the chair thing and had almost nothing on and shaking her butt toward the audience, I was thinking, how in the world did a wife, a mother, an adult person do something like that? I wonder,
that's the other thing. Yeah, they really have invited Americans into their family life. You know, they talk about their kids. I think Jay-Z even made a joke about his toddler's sippy cup while he was accepting one of the awards.
Yes.
So, you know, for people who say, oh, this is, you know, this is just a stage act that they're performing, they've obviously decided that their private life is public. And so who can possibly not think about them as husband and wife while they're standing there doing
that? That's right. That's right. What I don't understand, and hopefully you can help me, Beyonce is, she's already popular. She's well-known worldwide. She's made a name for herself. Why do you think at this point in life she needed to perform in that manner?
That is what is to me is so shocking. Beyonce could stand there in an evening gown.
Yes.
She has a beautiful voice. Unlike some other pop stars that people say, oh, they don't really have much of a voice. The only thing there is the show. People often say this about Madonna, for instance. The only thing that they have going for them is, you know, the wacky things they can do on stage. But Beyonce, she has this amazing voice. She was performing the Star Spangled Banner, you know, before the president. Why does she need to dress like that in order to get attention? She doesn't need to dress like that in order to get attention. She doesn't need to dress like that in order to get fans or money. It's just this whole notion that popular culture, your job as a popular culture figure is to push the envelope. But there are many, many singers who have resisted that. I don't think you'd see Mary J. Blige standing up there looking like that. I think you'd see a lot of other singers who said, you know, I'm here to show off my voice, not to show off my body.
In the little time that's left here, I want to talk to you about this post-racial world of Jerry Seinfeld, and you wrote that apparently he was asked about the race issue and his show. Let me first just play this quick soundbite for the folks so that they can get an idea of what I'm talking about here. Let's see here. This was from The Blaze. Jerry was on BuzzFeed Racial, where he responded to the racial question. Here is the question about Jerry's mostly white male guest on his show.
I have noticed that most of the guests are mostly white males of 22 episodes.
Yeah,
that you've
let's
had.
Get into that.
No, but you
take a look over here, Peter. What do you see? A lot of whiteies. What's going on here? this really pisses me off. But
well,
go
no,
ahead.
No, no,
really pisses me off.
Well, that's okay. I'm
go
sorry.
Ahead.
And just another quick soundbite on that. Jerry's asked, is this the census or something? And he says that I have no interest in gender or race. It's PC nonsense.
Now you
but there were a lot of things about Comedians in Cars in the beginning. The first 10 I did, I think, were all white males. And people were writing all about that, which
that's part of the reason why I asked. People had tweeted at me when I said I'm interviewing with Jerry Seinfeld. Oh, okay, ask him about their gender diversity on the show.
Yeah, I mean, it's people think it's the census or something. I mean, this has got to represent the actual pie chart of America. Who cares? It's just funny. You know, funny is the world that I live in. You're funny, I'm interested. You're not funny, I'm not interested.
Okay.
And I have no interest in gender or race or anything like that. But everyone else is kind of with their little calculating. Is this the exact right mix? You know, I think that's to me, it's anti-comedy. It's
okay.
Anti-comedy. It's more about, you know, PC nonsense.
Okay.
Than are you making us laugh or not?
Right. Right.
Yep. Naomi, I am so sick of the race issue, I can throw up. Why can't we just be Americans?
It is amazing to me. I mean, here you have one of the, you know, funniest guys, you know, in America. You get to interview him, and what do you want to cross-examine him about? Why there is not more, you know, racial or gender diversity on his show. What a laugh. I'm so sick of this, and this is the way that we have been taught to look at the world. We you know, we show up at a business or a school or a party, and the first thing we have to do is count to make sure there's enough diversity there.
Yeah.
So that we look politically correct. It doesn't matter who you are. There was an insane article a few weeks ago online that got a lot of play by a woman who realized that there was only one black woman in her yoga class. And she goes home and she has this crisis about, you know, how bad she feels. This woman must feel out of place, blah, 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 blah. You know, she doesn't go over to introduce herself, welcome the woman, say, glad you're here, blah, blah. Instead, she goes home and has some crisis about how she doesn't live in a diverse enough world.
You
it's
know,
crazy.
It is. It's just so insane. I now wonder, will we ever go back to being normal? When I watch Jerry's show, I used to love that show. It was so funny. Everybody on there were funny. It just never occurred to me that he did not or did have black people on there. I just saw a man who had great talent and was entertaining us. It just never occurred to me about the color thing.
Well, we have to look at the world that way. And by the way, could you imagine if he did, you know, the people on Jerry Seinfeld's show were not very nice people often. Can you imagine if one of them was a black character? Oh. Then he would have come under all this criticism for having a mean black character on the show.
Absolutely.
I mean, to me, it is hard to imagine how we are going to go back. It is, Clarence Thomas just said something, I think yesterday, about how we think about race too much now. And we're constantly walking on eggshells worrying about how sensitive we are, how diverse our environment is, and I think it's making everybody not see people for who they are, just see people for the color of their skin, which is the exact opposite of what one might hope for.
He said, yeah, Clarence said, Justice Thomas said back when he was going to high school, he believed that he was the only and first black kid at an all-white school back in the 60s, and the color issue never came up. It wasn't a big deal. It just was not about color. We're more color conscious now than we were back then when things were supposed to have been bad for black Americans.
Right. Can you imagine that today if you were the only black kid at the school? That's all anyone would ever talk about.
Yes.
How do you feel today? How is your race affecting you? How is it all affecting all of us? Let's have another race discussion. I mean, it would be impossible today.
It's so unfortunate for our country that this is happening. You also write about back in California passed a law concerning affirmative action and universities here in California that you cannot bring someone into a university based on color. And they passed a law, and now the government here, the local government, want to overturn that law and allow kids to come in based on color.
Yes, yes. No, we're going backwards. Proposition 209 was passed by a ballot initiative. It won the popular support of Californians, and now the legislature wants to put something on the ballot this November to get it overturned. It's amazing how we seem to be going backwards when it comes to thinking about race, which is that we're always thinking more about it instead of thinking less about it.
I find that to be unfortunate for black Americans, too, this affirmative action thing based on color, because it says that blacks are not smart enough or they won't put the effort into showing their own abilities. They're letting them in simply because of their color. So it's like a put down to black Americans. And for some reason, they don't seem to be embarrassed by that.
No, absolutely not. I mean, and they've been, the message is you deserve this because of, you know, past discrimination. And, but the real problem, I think the worst problem for black Americans of affirmative action is often, you know, the black Americans get put into a situation where they've been shown to be less likely to graduate from some of the most elite institutions, whereas they would have graduated from a slightly less elite institution. And now they are without a college degree at all so that a white person can say, look how diverse my school is.
Yeah. We have a minute left here. You write about the fact that you're now married to a black man, and when you first met him or he asked you would your parents accept him, and that was, you were surprised by that question.
Yeah, I mean, when I was dating, one of the things that was always an issue for me is that I'm Jewish and I wanted to raise my children Jewish, and that was sort of the issue that was always at the forefront of my mind. It wasn't this idea that I was going to have a problem, you know, with dating or marrying a black man.
Right.
You know, literally when we had this conversation, had not occurred to me. But you know, I think unfortunately we're all forced to think about race much more now than we would.
Naomi, thank you, and God bless you for what you're doing. I appreciate you being here this morning.
Thanks for having me.
All right, now back in a moment.